Yeah. I look ridiculous.
Hey, Walter talked about this guy named Brill Cream. Says he was the smartest guy around. You find that guy, I bet he'll figure out how to escape the city.
Brill Cream? What kind of a name is that?
One that's easy to remember, I guess. Anyway, Walter said there was ham radio signals coming from a Japanese museum nearby. Might be him. You should check it out.
Alright, plan B.
Hey, I bet you're wondering how Walter and I ended up together.
I just assumed you were twin brothers. So many similarities.
We met at a party. Or was it the DMV? I can't remember. Anyway, one thing I do remember is Walter didn't judge me for how I looked, how I talked, how I dressed. He told me, don't judge people, judge their actions. He kind of a zen motherfucker that way, and I loved him for it. He and I talked about you a lot.
Oh, my character moment sense is tingling.
There's something special about you, but it's buried beneath a whole lot of wise ass.
Oh, gee whiz, thanks for the revelation, Freud. Damn it, I just proved your point, didn't I?
Like I said, man, I don't think you have just the actions. My point is, don't let you get in the way of yourself.
Did you just cook up a philosopher amp or something?
Wee.
So basically, the anti-me.
Hey, you said it, not me.
Be defeated by a locked door. Plan B, to the roof.
I'm a ninja breaking into a Japanese museum.
Oh, I'm stupid.
How did you get in here?
I'm looking for a guy named Brill Cream.
Troopmaster Brill Cream is missing.
Well, maybe I can help you find him.
maybe you'll be lucky if I let you live.
Kind of a dick, huh?
Treason! Arrest Forkim and banish her from the troop!
Chill out, Mussolini.
I am the troop master, and this is my troop!
Man, are you gonna tell me where Brill Cream is or what?
You wanna find Brill Cream? You must do as I say.
Oh my god, fucking cringe.